In the previous video, I went over how to check the spatial reference system and use a project tool to create copies of the data. In this video, I will show you how to add XY data. On the Humboldt State Geospatial online website, I am currently on step 31. However, just for future reference, be aware that these numbers sometimes change. In ArcMap, open the catalog window. In the original folder, locate the text file called celltower.txt. Double-click the text file to view the contents in Notepad. Tab delimited is one of the simplest forms of spatial data. In this text file, each column of data is separated by a tab. The column headers are location number, city, latitude, and longitude. It is the last two columns, latitude and longitude, that are necessary to place this information on a map. When I talk about XY data, the longitude in decimal degrees is the X coordinate, and the latitude in decimal degrees is the Y coordinate. ArcMap will read these numbers, the latitude and longitude values in decimal degrees, in order to figure out where to place the points on the map. There is a catch to this, and it often leads to trouble. ArcMap only reads the decimal degree values from the text file. It does not know to which spatial reference system these values belong. To understand this, it is important to remember that each diegetic datum has a unique set of latitude and longitude values. For example, the latitude and longitude values for the clock tower at Humboldt State University using the World Geodetic Datum of 1984 will be different than the latitude and longitude values of the North American datum of 1927. Likewise, the North American datum of 1983 will use another set of latitude and longitude values to define the location of the clock tower. When adding XY data, the ArcGIS software only reads the decimal degrees. It does not know to which spatial reference system these decimal degree values belong. Worse yet, ArcMap will try to guess. When ArcMap guesses incorrectly, your points will end up somewhere they don't belong. Whenever you add XY data in ArcMap, you have to tell it which spatial reference system the latitude and longitude values belong to. I will demonstrate how to do this in the next few steps. The latitude and longitude values in this file happen to belong to the geographic coordinate system, WGS 1984. In Notepad, go ahead and close the cell tower text file. From the File menu, go to File, then Add Data, then Add XY Data. Click the yellow file folder icon and navigate to your original folder. Choose the cell tower text file and click Add. ArcMap will automatically locate the longitude and latitude fields. However, don't rush the next few steps. This is where most students make mistakes. Take a moment to read through the lower half of the window. It says, Coordinate System of Input Coordinates. Below that is a description of the input coordinates. ArcMap does not know what spatial reference system these latitude and longitude values come from, but it tries to guess. It assumes the spatial reference of the XY data is the same as the spatial reference currently used by the data frame. In this instance, ArcMap thinks the latitude and longitude values belong to NAD 1983. We know this is incorrect. The latitude and longitude values in this file belong to the geographic coordinate system, WGS 1984. To fix this, I have to tell ArcMap which coordinate system these decimal degree values belong to. This is called defining the spatial reference. On the lower right side, click the Edit button. Scroll all the way to the top. Open the Geographic Coordinate Systems folder. Scroll down and open the World folder. From the list, choose WGS 1984, then click OK. You should now see the coordinate system of input coordinates defined as GCS WGS 1984. It is important to remember that whenever you obtain latitude and longitude values from the internet, this spatial reference will be the most common one used. Make a note of these steps. It is very likely that you'll have to repeat them sometime in the future. On the Add XY Data window, click OK. Take a moment to read the warning. When you add XY data, ArcMap creates a temporary representation of the data. It might look like a normal shapefile, but it does not have a database. To make it into a permanent shapefile with a database, you'll have to export the layer. Go ahead and click OK to close the warning. In the table of contents, right-click on the cell tower layer and select Data, then Export Data. Click the yellow file folder icon and navigate to your working folder. Change the file type to shapefile. I'll call the file Cell Tower WGS84. When you are ready, click Save, then OK. On the next question, do you want to add the exported data to the map as a layer? Click Yes. Open the Arc Toolbox and use a Project tool to create a copy of the data with a spatial reference NAD83, UTM Zone 10 North. For the output, don't forget to click the yellow file folder icon and navigate to your working folder. I'll call the file Cell Tower UTM 10 North. From the working folder, add the new cell tower shapefile to the map. Remove the temporary events layer and the cell tower WGS layer. You now have completed the data preparation for this analysis and have all of the layers that you will need. In the next video, I will show you how to use attribute queries to narrow down the location for the music festival.